You know, Planned Parenthood hates Brian Sims more than they hate us because he's the reason that we all showed up here.
I'm Anders Hagstrom here with the Daily Caller News Foundation. I'm here with Matt Walsh in Philadelphia at the Planned Parenthood that Brian Sims accosted a few pro-life protesters.
Who would have thought that an old white lady would be out in front of a Planned Parenthood telling people what's right for their bodies? Shame on you.
What I should have shown you in that video was protesters gathered together to pray at, not to silently pray for, people coming in and out of Planned Parenthood. I've seen women and girls circle that block 2, 3, 4 times before finally driving away because they know that they weren't going to get in because of those protesters.
We will not be silenced. So Brian, maybe now you understand something, but if you try to shut us up, we're only going to get louder. And if you try to shame us, we're only going to stand taller.
Why do you think what he was doing to these people on the sidewalk was so dangerous?
I think it was dangerous in two ways. I think dangerous for the individual pro-lifers when you're putting $100 out for anyone to come up with their address. I mean, you are implicitly exposing them to the potential of violence. And it seems like what you're saying is, I mean, why do you want to know their addresses in the first place? What are you going to do with that information? That's a question we can ask. So it's dangerous in that way. But I also think, fortunately, it ended up being very dangerous in a sense for the pro-abortion movement. I think today, you know, Planned Parenthood hates Brian Sims more than they hate us because he's the reason that we all showed up here. So in the end, it backfired. I think it worked out a lot worse for the pro-abortion people than it did for us. The growth of it was completely organic. It was just, this started on Monday as an idea, now it's Friday, and it grew organically. This is grassroots. I think it's awesome.
And you said you invited Brian Sims, or live action, and everyone invited Brian Sims, and he didn't come. What would you have said to him if he did come?
I would give him a chance to explain himself. What I would like to do, if he cares, is tell him why we're all here. Tell him why we care so much about this issue. Why are we pro-life? I can explain that. His unwillingness to explain his own position, instead choosing to pick on, you know, women and children, I think should tell us something about his position. He's not confident in it, you know. I'm not going to try to shout anyone down. I am very eager for the chance to talk about this issue because I know that I'm right.
Yeah.
We're all right.
And he said in those videos, I can't remember which, whether it was the old woman or the teenagers, that essentially being pro-life is a inherently religious position. Do you agree with that? Do you think anyone who isn't religious can be pro-life?
No, not at all. I don't think. I think certainly if you believe in God, if you're a Christian. If you're a Christian, certainly you really have, there's no way to be a pro-abortion Christian. It's just not an option available to you. But even if you're not religious, in a way you could say that if you don't believe in God, then abortion is arguably even more of a travesty because these children only get the one life. This is their one shot at existence. And so to take that from them and to send them into nothingness, which is where you think they're going, is a travesty. So no, I think that this is an issue that cuts across religious boundaries, cuts across all boundaries.